All right, hello, art people. We are on our second video for this exit slip. I just need to go ahead and finish up my blanket designs here for my Kama Llama. I am on my eighth one, just adding some diagonal lines here. So let's go ahead and finish these up together. Like I said in the last video, you don't have to do the same patterns as me. I would actually prefer if you came up with your own, but you can copy mine. Or there's also a worksheet on the left of my screen, not a worksheet, but a paper with some more pattern ideas that you can copy. So go ahead and get to drawing, get to working on those. I'm working on my last one, just drawing some circles, some big ones, medium ones, and some little ones. So anytime a picture or a line or a shape is repeated, it is called a pattern. So everybody say pattern. Pattern. So that's a really good art vocabulary word that we can learn with this lesson. Anything that is repeated. So repeat after me. A pattern is a motif that is repeated. Very good. And a motif just means, well, a line, a shape, a color, a picture, whatever, whatever. All right, now let's go ahead and color. So we are going to be using our colored pencils to color. As you can see, your colored pencils are organized by color, or they should be. They should be in rainbow order. So I'm just going to fix my box here real quick. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, and the neutral colors, black, white, and brown on the bottom. And you'll see that each can has a different color. In my particular box, purple and pink live together. So when you grab a pencil, you can only get one pencil at a time, of course. And then when you're done with that pencil, you have to put it back before you get the next pencil. And that's how we keep our art supplies all organized here. So for our first design, we're going to color whatever color we want. And if there's a color that we want to use and we don't have it, or the pencil is broken and there's not one in the can that works, you're just going to order that color by putting a clip on the rainbow card where that color is, just like we order colors for everything else in this art class. So make sure you're using your order form if you need to fill, if you need a color. All right, so let's go ahead and all color our first blanket, and only color one of them. Do not color any more, just one. Go ahead. Thank you. Okay, so now that we have finished our first square, what we are going to do is learn about the color families. So the first color family I want to teach you about is primary colors. As you can see that I'm pointing to here, it's red, yellow, and blue. Those are in the color family called primary colors. So colors are just one of our elements of art. I got that poster from the wall above my bulletin board. But anyway, we are going to color our next blanket with the primary colors, red, yellow, and blue. So go ahead and grab either red, yellow, or blue and start coloring your second square. Now you don't want to fill it all the way up, right? Because you need room for the other two colors as well. So go ahead and color with your first color, either red, yellow, or blue. All right, you can put that first primary color away now and get out another primary color. So either red, yellow, or blue. And then you can color on that same blanket with that color and leave something blank for your last primary color, okay? Okay, and put that second primary color away and get your last one out. So either red, yellow, or blue, whichever one you haven't used yet, and fill the rest of this blanket design with that last primary color. Okay, it is time to put our last primary color away. So I will now be teaching you guys about another color family. So we learned about primary colors. Now we're going to learn about secondary colors. So they are down here on the bottom of our color poster, and they are orange, green, and purple, as you can see here. So what we do, if we had paint out, we could mix these primary colors, two of them, to make one of the secondary colors. Red and blue make purple. So our primary colors are all the way around our color wheel here, and in between blue and red we have purple, because red and blue make purple. That's our first secondary color. In between red and yellow we have orange. That's another secondary color. And in between blue and yellow, we have green. That's another secondary color. So see, we can take the primaries, mix them together, and make the secondary colors, purple, green, and orange. So our next blanket is going to be colored just with those. So go ahead and either get out green or purple or orange and start coloring your next blanket design. Thank you. Okay, you can go ahead and put away that secondary color and get out another secondary color. So remember, it's either orange, green, or purple. And go ahead and start coloring with your second secondary color. And now it is time to put that away and get out your final secondary color, either orange, green, or purple, whichever of those colors you have not used yet. Okay, so now we are done with our third blanket design, so let's put that away. And I'm going to now teach you about another color family, and this is the neutral colors. So the neutral colors have white, gray, brown, and black in them, and so that is what we will be using for our fourth design for our llama blankets. So we don't actually have a lot of gray colored pencils in this classroom, but that's okay because our normal drawing pencils are gray, aren't they? So we can always just use that for the gray. So go ahead and either get out the gray, the brown, or the black and start coloring. Oh, and also we don't need to use our white colored pencil when we have the white in, when we are going to do the white, because our paper is white. So all we have to do to make sure that we have white in this is to leave some of your design blank. So anyway, go ahead and either use your normal drawing pencil for gray or brown or black, and let's start adding to this design. Once you're done with your first neutral color, get out another neutral color and start adding that to your design. Remember, it's gray, brown, and black that we're doing, and we're leaving some space white. Alright, you're probably done with your second neutral color now, so you can put it away and get out your last neutral color. And I'm going to remind you one last time to just leave some of the area in this design white, because one of our neutral colors is white, so keep some of it blank. Wow, great job, you guys. So you have learned three different color families: primary colors, secondary colors, neutral colors. Now I'm going to teach you another color family. These are called the cool colors. They are so cool. They're like cold kind of feeling. And they are all on the same side of the color wheel. So I'll cover the side up here for a different color family. And what you can see now are the cool colors. So greens, blues, and purples are all cool fall colors. Now, pink, it doesn't really belong to either the cool color family or the warm color family. She's just a friend. So you can do pink with your cool colors, or you can do pink with your warm colors. I'll let you decide that yourself. But for our next design, our next blanket design, we're going to use blue, green, and purple. So go ahead and get either your blue, your green, or your purple out and start coloring on your fifth design. Okay, great job. So you're probably done with your first cool color, so you can put that away and get your second cool color out, either green, purple, or blue. Or if you wanted to do pink, I'm letting you do pink for cool colors as well. All right, you're probably done with your second cool color, so let's get out our last cool color, either green, purple, or blue. Go ahead and get that out. So in this blanket design, you need to have all of these three colors, green, purple, and blue. Okay, if you also have pink, remember that's okay, but pink's not really a cool color. She's a friend of the cool color family. So you can add her if you want, but you definitely need green, purple, and blue. All right, as you guys finish that up, I'll just let you know what's going to be happening in the next video. Well, we're going to finish coloring our designs, and I'm going to continue to teach you about color families. The next color family I'll be teaching you about is the warm colors. So, great job on this video, and I'll see you in the next one.